I think the most important thing that I do in my job is to empower people.
It is their human right to access what they want and not be held back because of staffing issues or lack of funding.
The main attribute needed to work in the ID sector, I would think, is patience, patience, and probably more patience.
When you go in the doors of your workplace and somebody that you're supporting for the day, a service user, looks and there's a big wide smile, they mightn't use words, but their smiles and their gestures, you know that you're appreciated for the work that you do.
I think generally people who work in intellectual disability hate unfairness. They hate, you know, seeing people not getting a fair shot at things, and I think that's part of what drives them.
A lot of my job would be building self-confidence and finding opportunities for what service users want to do. Everyone is an individual and they all have dreams.
So I've been working in residential. It's a 24/7 service. It's basically somebody's home. Two gentlemen live there. One individual is profoundly deaf as well as having an intellectual disability. So really, I suppose a typical day is just to help them to lead as good a life within their home and in the community as possible.
We try and encourage the people that we work with to use their own form of communication, whether it's pictures, whether it's sign language. Our role would be to take a step back and make sure that their voice is heard in whatever form that they can express themselves.
I've been here for the last going on 17 years. I enjoy the work. This is very, very important for people with disabilities to have a job, have self-worth and believe in themselves.
We're always left behind in funding. Zero-hour contracts being huge, people can't get mortgages, can't do anything really, they don't know if they're coming or going. It's really difficult work and it's long hours, and people on low wages, zero-hour contracts get very disheartened and end up leaving.
Services have said to us that it's very, very important that the people that support them, they're consistently coming in. They build a relationship with staff. Staff know their likes, they know their needs. They know when they need quiet time, they know when they need to go out and about and meet friends. I think it's very important that there is permanent jobs in our sector and that they can develop and build the skills of people that we support and work on independent living skills to help people access their community.
If we didn't have the trade union, I think that there would have been privatisation everywhere already, especially the Section 39s would not have the level they have right now. Even when I started in my new place, to get a contract is basically unheard of. I was very lucky, and I think that was the union strength helped that, to walk into a contracted job instead of a zero-hour contract.
Trust and care is agreed between the unions and the employers as the only way forward in terms of complaints and procedures. If there's to be changes made, it should be certainly done inclusively, including unions who've agreed to it, employers who've agreed to it. The assault in the workplace, we actually don't have a policy, and I certainly think that there should be a standardised assault policy.
You're not going to walk in as a staff member in ID sector and say there's no issues. You're going to have an issue probably a week in, because you're going to be upset by the fact that there's no funding. Why can't I do my job? Well, there's no funding. You know, there's going to be issues, and the only way we can fight this is by getting our voice heard, and the only way we're going to get our voice heard is by being part of the union and SIPDU getting our message out there.
I think it's very important that we come together to make sure that we're treated with respect and dignity and equality within our job.